Here's my answer.
Celeste.
It was Celeste.
Yep, Celeste. Man, we are on fire with this. We're going to zoom in past.
I'm a suspicious individual now, am I? I really do hate this kind of joke.
A joke? I wonder.
Celeste, you're a part of this. You're basically like the main event here. You found everything. You saw everything. You are just... You're doing everything.
Saying, then, is that I specifically chose to work together with Hifumi. The idea that I would choose to spend any amount of time interacting with him, that I would go within 10 feet of that
damn
shit for brains, that lazy, worthless, goddamn idiot! pardonnez-moi.
Just to be clear, there is evidence to support it.
Is that so?
It is. Throughout the investigation, there was certain behavior.
Oh yeah, the behavior, for sure. For sure, the behavior.
Considering what we've learned so far, it only further proves that the two of you were working together.
You guys were in cahoots. Screaming? Nope. It's an encounter then. Shit. Yeah, you two are the only ones that encountered. That makes sense. That makes sense, yeah.
The suspicious individual in the suit, doesn't it? The only ones who ever actually saw Robo Justice firsthand were Celeste and Hifumi.
Shush, the adults are talking.
Fuck you, Togami. You're not even...
Sorry.
As he said,
we're all in high school still.
Celeste and Hifumi ever laid eyes on the costumed individual.
In fact, I'm not.
If we accept that Hifumi was one of the culprits, we can't help but suspect what Celeste has said as well.
Are you saying everything they told us was a lie?
Yeah.
After taking Hifumi to the nurse's office, we all began our search for this individual, correct? And not too long after that, do you remember what Celeste said?
I was definitely too early on the draw with the screaming, though. I saw a shadow, something moving around the top of the stairs.
We headed to the second floor specifically because of what she claimed to have seen.
And you know why she did that?
Next,
to draw
us all to
away.
The physics lab up on the third floor.
She let out a blood-curdling scream.
She was instigating all of our movements here.
And when we'd all come to see what was wrong, what was it she said?
What's wrong? Rather intense scream. Like, even Togami knows when that scream happened. I saw him, the strange costume man. He ran off as soon as he screamed, and we didn't find the person. He was supposed to be on the third floor.
Once she'd done her job of getting us all up to the physics lab,
it was Ifumi's job next.
It was time
yep.
for her partner to get to work.
Oof, they were totally in cahoots with each other. That came downstairs must have been Ifumi.
It was
makes
to get us
sense.
To divide into two groups, so that we would discover both bodies at the same time?
And confuse us from the very beginning.
In fact, Celeste was precisely the one who proposed that we split up.
Everything is just unraveling now. At the seams, she's done. Leaving the hunting party seems much more interesting. Very well, Makoto, Hina, come with me in the nurse's office. Leave the captured decision visual Toko, Byakuya, and Sakura.
Well, if Celeste and Hifumi were working together, all those chance events suddenly become connected. And on top of that, that piercing cry of yours early on.
Too suspicious.
That was to signal Hifumi, wasn't it? It was your way of telling him, we're on the third floor. Everything's going according to plan.
Yes.
Why else would you let out a scream that could have carried across the sea?
I just realized another strange thing. When we found Hifumi in the nurse's office, who we now know was only pretending to be dead.
Certainly was not expecting you this. She's telling the truth there. Do not imagine that Hifumi would be murdered.
Celeste,
nope, now I'm lying.
You were the first one to say he'd been murdered.
I'm being an idiot. I thought she'd be something about the blood, but yeah, I guess that makes sense too.
You wanted to make sure we wouldn't have any doubt in our minds.
I'm kind of lost.
I don't believe it. Everything. The whole thing was one big act.
Hina, you were with Celeste when Hifumi's body disappeared,
She moved Asahina away too.
Yeah. I was feeling kind of sick, so Celeste took me to the bathroom. Wait! Then that was...
So Hifumi can move!
She wasn't worried about you. She just saw a chance to help Hifumi sneak out of the nurse's office.
Each piece isn't much by itself, but start putting them together and the picture gets very ugly indeed. Wouldn't you agree, Celeste?
Celeste, why did you say something, Celeste?
I have no idea what you mean.
Celeste, come on.
Don't bother trying to deny
it. You lost.
You made one fatal mistake.
What is it, Togami?
Oh, did I?
Hey, Togami, what is it?
I didn't even catch it myself when you first said it, but looking back, I can say that that one little slip-up was your undoing.
What is it, Togami?
What are you
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about what you said after Hifumi's body disappeared and we returned to the nurse's office.
Let's really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around fighting confused. We're all gonna die here. Gonna die, guys. Just like those guys died.
I remember her saying
oh,
that
he actually
too,
did. He actually showed us.
I don't understand what's so strange about her.
Then pay attention. Sakura, Toko, and I were first to discover Taka's body in the equipment room. Then Makoto showed up and told us Hifumi had been killed. So Sakura and I left with Makoto. Once we were in the hall, we ran into Celeste, and the four of us headed to the nurse's office. Now, the entire time we were together, none of us said anything about Taka being dead. Think about it. Celeste's comment doesn't make sense. It was completely out of place.
Yeah, I see what you're talking about. Although I don't really get what it means.
You hear that, Celeste? Everyone's having some trouble understanding. Could you repeat what you said?
I can't believe Togami actually took this one this time.
If you're really not the culprit, you shouldn't have any problem repeating it, right?
Go ahead. Since that last comment doesn't make sense, what is he alluding to? Alright, well, here we go. I guess I'm gonna say it anyways. Monokuma number 3. What? Why are we getting this one? Wait, what?
All I said was... They must really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. They must be positively elated. We are all going to die here. We are going to die, just like those guys died.
Oh wait, no.
And that is all I said.
And that's all it takes to finish this. It's obvious, isn't
it? Yeah.
What was so strange about Celeste's comment?
But shit. It's those guys. She didn't know Taka died, so. Is it really the Monokuma file?
All I said was...
I might as well try.
They must really be enjoying the sight of us. They must be perfect. We are all going to die here. We are going to die. Just like those
guys
died.
Your words, stop wasting time.
Shoot.
What?
All I said was... They must really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. They must be positively elated. We are all going to die here. We are going to die, just like those guys died. And that is all I said.
And that's all it takes to finish this. It's obvious, isn't it? What was so strange about Celeste's
comment? Maybe it is this. When she said that she only had known about Hifumi's death. That in mind, what's so strange about what she said is... Alright, so it is this.
They must really enjoy
right?
The sight of us, they must be... We are all going to die here. We are going to die.
Just like... No, that's wrong.
Alright, well... Yeah, I get it.
That's right. There's no reason Celeste should have said, just like those guys died.
And just like Mondo slipping up during this, Celeste slipped up just there.
When she said that, none of us had told her Taka was dead.
Exactly. And we didn't run into her until after we were all out in the hall. So there was never any chance for her to have seen his body in the equipment room.
So how did you know, Celeste?
Just like butter. Look at all that slipping around.
How did you know more than one person had been killed? And how did you know they were both guys? Because Kyoko had also disappeared, right? So she could have been dead too.
Oh, fuck. You're done.
You all have such vivid imaginations, you know that?
Imaginations?
You claim that I was lying when I told you about the suspicious person I saw. Then what about the picture?
You're bringing up the picture again, huh?
How do you explain this picture of the costumed villain dragging Hifumi away?
I can already explain this, so let's get on with it already.
It has to be some kind of setup, right? So let's put the suit on, and then she used the camera's timer to set up the picture.
Have you so quickly forgotten? You are the only one who could have possibly fit into that suit. Plus, I happen to know that this particular camera does not have a timer.
Celeste, why'd you do it?
In other words,
I guess I know why.
It's a fact that this is a picture of Hifumi being dragged away. If everything I told you was a
motive,
lie, how
incentive.
Can this picture exist?
Simple. Are we sure that's really a picture of the suspect dragging Hifumi away?
Kyoko gets it.
What could you possibly mean by that?
Surely there are other explanations than the one you've offered up.
No, there is no other explanation.
Other explanations? If it wasn't a picture of the suspect dragging Hifumi away. Only other possibility, Hifumi is dragging...
It's not a picture of the suspect dragging Hifumi away. I would say it's a picture of Hifumi dragging the suspect away.
That's certainly within the realm of possibility.
Kyoko didn't do that thing where she gave me a quick smile
that
time.
Isn't Hifumi, but the person in the robot suit.
That's still like weirding me out. I don't know why she did that.
Simply been led to believe that it's the other way around. And the strange costume might only exist to lead us astray even farther. If you saw someone wearing something like that in this situation, of course you'd notice and be suspicious.
That's what happened! You put me to sleep and made me out to be the bad guy in all this!
Such a thing is utterly impossible.
How?
Hifumi was dragging him away? Ridiculous.
Is it? I don't think it's ridiculous at all.
Yeah, it's definitely not.
Then shut your mouth.
Oh, fuck. Oh my god, shut down. Alright, Celeste thinks she can prove that there's no way Hifumi was dragging the suspect away. Is it really possible? Yeah, tell me. How is it possible? Tell me why it's impossible that could be a thing. Justice, it's your message. What's gonna be used here?
Dressed me up in that suit after I passed out. Then you just draped me across Hifumi and had him carry my weight. You tried to make me look like the bad guy.
Like I said, ridiculous. As you can see in the picture, the suspect is standing perfectly upright. If the person inside the suit was unconscious, there's no way they could stand up straight like that.
And the fortune-telling idiot is the culprit after all!
No way!
Rahina said she said that she couldn't bend at the waist.
You dressed me up in that suit after I passed out! Then you just draped me across Hifumi and had him carry my weight! You tried to make me look like the bad guy!
Like I said, as you can see in the picture, the suspect, if the person inside the suit was uncaught, there's no way they could stand up straight like that.
No, that's all they could do, I guess. I'm going through this. I understand.
No.
Everything.
Even if the person inside the suit were unconscious, they could still stand up like
I'm
that.
Still lost though.
Because that Robo Justice suit had a certain characteristic.
Cat bent the way seems like pretty obvious oversights.
That's right.
All he can do is stand up at the
totally
just stand up straight.
They made it, so it couldn't bend at the waist.
I'm not so sure that was a mistake. I think the suit was designed from the beginning to be used the way it was.
Oh, whoa, look at you. Get a little,
took the suit they'd specially designed and stuffed Hiro into it.
Getting a little nervous there, Celeste.
That's how they were able to fake that whole thing. The point of it all was to make us believe whoever was in the suit was to blame.
Well then, I suppose this is checkmate.
Celeste, just take it. Don't. I know you're gonna die. Yeah, we all know you're gonna die. So I guess you gotta fight, no matter what, right?
Don't make me laugh, you idiot! What do you mean, checkmate?
Jeez, alright. She's scary.
Celeste? Clearly, you wanna cram me into your little guilty.
Oh, there's something that she has up her sleeve still. Oh, shit. Shit.
Have you
already dying
what?
Message.
Fumi told us as he lay dying?
Well, who attacked you? Who tried to kill you? Kill me. Name Yasu Hiro. You gotta go over that thing.
Him, his answer was quite clear, was it not?
Your voice is changing.
He said, and I quote, Yasu Hiro. In other words, Yasu Hiro Hakakurei!
Wait, but my name isn't really Yasuhiro. It's actually Taro.
What?
Your confusing statements don't make any sense. You're
what?
Only making things more
your name is Taro?
He did say Yasuhiro, but are we sure he was really pointing the finger at Hiro?
There is something we don't know. That could be the reason he said that and we're confused about it.
You'll
burn her alive. That's not very nice, Celeste. Burning people alive? Come on now.
What do you mean by that?
Why would you do that?
Think back to how Hifumi used to talk to us. How did he refer to each of us?
I got it.
People's last names.
That's right. Our last names. He called us all by our last names.
Exactly. I know I heard him say Mr. Nayagi more than once, for example. So if Hifumi did mean to say Hiro's name, he would have said his last name, Hagakure.
I'm sure it was just incidental. By chance, he just... his first name... indecent?
Don't talk.
Random chance. Now isn't that a convenient explanation? No. There's no reason to think he would have said the name any different than normal. But he must have run out of energy before he could say any more.
So Hifumi was trying to tell us the last name of whoever killed him?
He remembers.
But the name he said doesn't apply to anyone here.
Well, there is someone here that doesn't have two names in their text box. And it so happens to be the person we're accusing right now.
No, hold on. There's one person it could apply
to. All we have to do is ask for their real name. And things will be over.
Celeste. She never actually told us what her real name is.
Yep, there it is.
What did you just say?
Yeah, tell me, Celeste. Tell us, Celeste. Tell the class. What's your real name, Celeste?
You think you'd take your false accusation so far? I don't know whether to laugh or spit.
And that's where the e-handbooks come into play. It says her real name.
Blather. Yasuhiro is a loser's name. Do I look like a loser to you?
I mean, you're losing right now, so.
Well, do I? What? I
Then fill us in. What's your real name?
Celestia Ludenberg.
Make sure your ear holes are wide open and listen up! My real name is Celestia Ludenberg. Could you please stop making me repeat myself over and over again?
Celestia won't give up, so then, something to make her accept it. Let's go. E-handbooks. Give me that bullet. There it is. See, it clicked this time.
Ifumi was trying to tell us something.
And Kyoko knew immediately.
He wanted us to know the killer's last name. Yasuhiro.
If there's one person here who might have that last name...
It would have to be you, Celeste. You haven't told anyone what your real name is.
How many times do I have to tell you? My name is...
Celestia Ludenberg, god damn it!
How long do you plan to go on pretending?
That's amazing.
I'm not pretending. It's the truth. And since you have no way to contradict me...
What?
That's the only truth there is! Moron!
Moron? Jesus. Alright, well, I know where it is now, so...
wanted us to know the killers. If there's one person...
It would have to be you, Select.
How many times...
It's time to put it to rest.
I'm not pretending. And since you have no way to contradict me...
Oh, my...
That's the only truth there is!
I have to get rid of that!
Moron.
God damn it. Alright. I can't believe Kyoko knew this would come into play.
He wanted us to know the
killer. We all knew her name wasn't actually Celestia Lindbergh. It's like she immediately knew who did it.
You have no way to contradict me.
Fuck! Oh wow, the time actually goes faster too, the time limit. Celestia Ludenberg, goddammit.
And since you have no way to contradict.
No, that's wrong.
Sorry, I shall you. Whoa.
That's it. The handbook.
What?
Anytime you turn your handbook on, it shows the owner's name when it boots up, right? Monokuma told us all about it before.
That book is absolutely vital to a healthy school life, so don't lose it. When you start it up, it will display your name. Always make sure you have the right one. Now, this is not your everyday notebook. It has so many more uses than that. It has
so
definitely had way more uses.
Check her handbook, and that'll clear up everything. That's how we can find out Celeste's real name.
That's an invasion of privacy. I refuse to cooperate.
I'm sorry, Celeste.
Celeste.
Yeah, God.
Can you please just tell us what really happened? Please.
It's time to make a...
Just tell us.
Yeah. We're all tired about this. But I think it's time to make a comic book.
Even when I'm put in check, it's just my nature not to give up.
I guess you are the ultimate gambler or whatever.
Because...
Super high school level.
Fine then. Let me settle it.
It's time to draw this comic book.
Let me go over the case again, from the beginning, and shed light on all your crimes. And that'll bring everything to an end.
Definitely time. Time for the climax interview. Ew, look at Fumi's face. So we gotta get the hem, gotta get them handshaking there. Act 2, what time did the killers call the victim to the rec room? It was 1. And that's when they drugged him. Why do I have crystal ball, right? What is... Who was it that killer summoned first? Okay, they knocked him out and stuffed him in the robot justice suit to falsify their evidence, and they used a certain item to do it. I don't know what this is. Let me just look over it once more. See. Why do we have the poster too? Okay, those two are definitely like... Maybe it's this. It has, like, this whole page is just Hifumi struggling, so I'm just gonna assume that's it, right there. A time was Taka supposed to head to the equipment room. That was 6. And of course he'd be right on time, right? Maybe a little earlier. Oh man, look at him! He looks like a badass! You see that? Just hammer that was used to kill Taka, what number was it? It was... 4. Give a picture in the library of whom he used as something to fake the existence of the shadowy criminal. Maybe it's that. Wait, what is this? I hope this is right. Like, wait, hold on, where is it? If this isn't right, it might be this. I can't really tell what that is. Wait. No, this is just this right here. So maybe this isn't it. Alright, well, it's good to know. Then he put this, just hammer, was in the nurse's office room when Hifumi was planning to be dead. That would be 3. We found them, same time. Yeah, that's pretty impressive that they would time that perfectly. Hifumi used something to move to top of the body, that'd be the tarp and... What is this? Why are there chips here? This is definitely it though. I thought the blue was the justice. But no, it's definitely this, which in turn would mean that this. What is this? Look at his hair. What is this? Maybe it is this. Cause I can't see any of these being it either. I don't know what this would be though. Oh, you know what? This would be this. And then... Library of whom you use something to fake the existence of a shadowy criminal. I don't know what this is. I don't know what the chips are for. I don't think this is it. I don't think it is. Let's just go through all of this first and then, okay, there's one more left. Weapon the killer used to murder Hifumi, what was it? That would just be a regular hammer. Maybe, I don't think Justice Hammer 2 would be in it. Would it? Oh, you know, it is. Okay, this is it.
The killer is you! Before anything, the killer persuaded someone to help carry out the murder. And that person was...
Look at that face. Ew.
With an accomplice, the killer was able to execute a number of otherwise impossible schemes. First, they convinced someone to meet them in the rec room. Last night at 1 in the morning. That someone they met with was Hiro. The murderous duo intended to pass Hiro off as the prime suspect. So when they met up with him, they drugged him, knocked him out, and stuffed him into the Robo Justice suit. Next, Hifumi positioned himself to make it look like Robo Justice was attacking him. while the killer used a digital camera to take pictures of the assault. They did all this just to create evidence that would put the suspicion on Hiro. When they were done with him, they shoved him, still unconscious, into the pool room locker. And then finally, at 6 a.m., they moved into the murder phase of their plan. They called Taka to the equipment room. And that's where Hifumi killed him, making it the scene of the first murder. The murder weapon was Justice Hammer 4, which was left there in the equipment room. The reason hammer number 4 was used was to create confusion about the order of the crimes. So, next they falsified 2 more assault incidents. For these attacks, the killers pretended to be the victims to solidify Robo Justice as the suspect. The first fake incident was the attack in the rec room. There, the killers wanted us to see Justice Hammer 1 and the Robo Justice pictures they'd taken. They wanted to make sure we bought the surprise attack story. The second fake incident was the attack in the library. This time, they planted Justice Hammer 2 and an injured Hifumi to sell us that story. With these 2 incidents, the killers were able to create a certain preconception in our minds that the suspect was increasing the size of the hammers and attacking people in order as they did. We fell right into their trap and started looking for the suspect based on that. But while we did that, we left Hifumi alone in the nurse's office. This was exactly what Hifumi was hoping for. He took a blood packet from the refrigerator and Justice Hammer 3 and turned the room into a crime scene, in which he himself had apparently been brutally murdered. He let out a scream to draw us back, and when we returned, that's what we found. Meanwhile, the other group that had been out searching found Taka's body at the same time. So when we heard the body discovery announcement, we naturally assumed it was for Hifumi. We left the nurse's office, and Hifumi once again took advantage of the situation. He simply got up and made his escape. When we learned his body had disappeared, we all rushed back to the nurse's office. And once again, Hifumi had the chance he was waiting for. This time, he snuck into the equipment room. He wrapped Taka's body in a tarp and use the dolly to move it all the way down to the repository. That explains how each of the bodies disappeared. But even Hifumi didn't know what the true killer had in mind for their final act. Their plan all along was to kill Hifumi and get rid of the one person who could betray them. And they did it using an ordinary, everyday hammer from the repository. That should cover everything that happened in this case. And the villain behind it all is...
Still anime.
Celeste! Sorry, you lose.
Still anime. And there it is. Everything came together.
Lost?
Yep.
I lost? When was the last time I was forced to utter such words? They hang heavy around my neck.
Why'd you have to do it?
Then you admit it? You're the killer?
Listen to you, trying to take charge, as if you're my private instructor. I, Celestia Ludenberg. Actually, no. Taiko Yasuhiro is fine.
Taiko Yasuhiro.
Taiko?
So, you finally accepted it.
I'm the kind of person, once I've lost, I don't like things to drag on.
Interesting.
There it is. We did lose. But what's our rate gonna be? We got two B's this time. Oh no. Overall, we still got an A. Nice. 91 medals.